To archive and download your entire Facebook history, jump onto your Facebook account, log in, and on any page on Facebook on the desktop, you should see this down arrow. Click that and then go down to setting. Go ahead and press setting. And this is where you download a copy of your Facebook data. So let me go ahead and download it. Then I'm going to open it up to show you what Facebook has on you in a second. So let me go ahead and press download here. It'll take you to this page, download your information, get a copy of what you've shared on Facebook. So this is posts, videos, photos, messages, a lot of stuff on Facebook. Like I said, it's going to be stuff from 2004, 2005, whenever I signed up, all the way till now. I'll press start my archive. Now you need to type in your Facebook password. And then it's going to say, this may take a little while. I'm going to say, that's okay, start my archive. And the download request is going to go directly to my email. It did send me an email saying the download request has started, but once it's done, it's going to send it to the same email. I'm going to press okay here. And when it's all done, it's going to send me an email and let me know that it's complete. And I'll follow up right when it's done. The download is finally complete. In my case, it took about 30 minutes, and this is the email that Facebook sent me. So now I could click on the link they sent me to go ahead and download that information. I'll just have to press this download archive, and it'll start downloading right into my desktop here. And it says it's 300 megabytes. So the zip file is 300 megabytes. That's because the video and the audio and whatever else, the photos that were downloaded and archived are heavily compressed. So now let me go ahead and open the zip file on a Mac. I'll just have to click the zip file. It'll start expanding the zip file. So this is what is inside that zip file. If I look under video, I will see all the videos that I've uploaded over time. I'll see some of the thumbnails I've uploaded over time here. And under photos, I'll see all the photos that I've downloaded divided into different folders like this. So I could go through and see all the different folders that I've downloaded here from way back when. And under messages, I could see all the messages in HTML form. So if I open it, it looks something like this. So I could open each message by just pressing spacebar here or opening it in a browser. They all kind of look like this, but you'll see a ton of different messages here. It looks like there's almost 1,000 messages. And there is more photos and videos inside the messages folders too. So under HTML, let me go ahead and launch one of these just to show you what it looks like on the web browser. On the web browser, it looks like this. So you'll have all the application that you give Facebook permission to. Those are all listed here. You'll also see what Facebook has on your profile. These are all the things that Facebook knows about you, your family, your education, pretty much everything you've given it over the years, some of your likes. I could go to my timeline and see my timeline from the very beginning to the very end. I could see ads. These are the ad topics that I've clicked on that Facebook thinks I'm interested in. So Facebook knows a lot about you through this. And now you could see exactly what they know about you. So messages, pokes. These are all the friends you have, all the friend requests you've sent, even all the people that you've deleted on Facebook.